Do you need more storage? Just buy it.
A lot of people approach me asking, hey, what is the best SSD that I can buy right now? And I blindly suggest them the MX500. Why? Because it is cheap. And it is one of the best SSDs out there right now. Today, we will test this for real, and I have the 1TB variant in my hand. So let's get into the unboxing of this thing. The outer covering is quite modest and is made out of disposable cardboard. I like that, Crucial. And inside, we got this plastic caddy, which contains a black spacer, an insert, and the SSD. You can use these spacers to mount your SSD in case it's at the risk of wobbling. Mainly laptops need them. The SSD has an aluminium body with the mounting ports over on the back and on the sides, and the SATA and power connector over on the side. So, for the on-paper specs, this thing bears the model number Crucial MX500, is available in 250GB, 500GB, 1TB and 2TB variants, is available in both 2.5-inch and M.2 form factors with the SATA 6GBPS interface, has a TBW of 360TB for the 1TB variant and 700TB for the 2TB variant, sequential read of 560Mbps and write of 510Mbps, has DRAM caching all coupled with a 5-year warranty. So, you need two cables, a SATA cable and a power cable. Remember, this SSD has a SATA 3 interface, so don't get, let's say, a SATA 2 or a SATA 1 cable. That will just bottleneck the SSD's performance. So, both of these cables have a straight slot and this kind of a notch in them. You need to align this L with the port in your SSD and then put it in. There is only one way of putting this in, so there is no chance of messing it up. Be cool. After you align the port, just slide in gently and give it a thrust, and it will go in like that. Same way for the power cable, align it, then push it in. Okay, so there are a lot of ways in which you can install an SSD. Laptops may have a dedicated bay, or you may have to use a hard drive caddy if you want to swap out your optical drive for an SSD. Today, I'm going to show you two different ways of mounting your SSD into your desktop computer. Remember, these steps will vary from case to case. And if these steps don't match your case, simply skip this part to the review and benchmark section of this video. So, first of all, you may need to put it by screwing it in from the back of your case. And this is very common. I have seen this in a lot of cases. But the other way is using a drive mount. This is very unusual and I have not seen this in a lot of cases. You need the SSD, a drive mount, a 4-head screwdriver and a few screws. So, align your mount with the SSD and simply fasten those screws using the screwdriver. Now you just need another screw and simply install it on your case. It's fairly simple, I must say. Okay, lastly, you need to connect your SATA cable to the motherboard. It is just as we did with the SSD, just align up the little L's and put it into the port. And bam! We just installed the new SSD into our system. Okay, so the next thing that I did was cloning Windows from my hard drive to the solid state drive. I'll make a OS cloning video later down the line. It's pretty simple and saves a lot of time. So, after finally installing the SSD, I ran a few quick benchmarks. The crystal disk mark, which is fairly light and just checks the sequential read and write speeds of the SSD, got 561.07 in read and 513.56 in write, while working with 5 256MB files. And I am really impressed how well it keeps up the same performance while working with larger files. Moving over to Atom, it performs quite as expected. That's all for this benchmark. Now, how does this perform in real life? For Windows startup, BIOS time is around 8 to 8.5 seconds, and it took almost 30 seconds from pressing the power button to loading into the desktop. And that's quite fast. Just for a little comparison, it takes over a minute to boot with your hard drive. Recently, I have been playing Mad Max, and the load times were surprising as compared to my old Toshiba 1TB drive. Now it's time to compare the Crucial with other competitors in its range. Starting up with the endurance, it is almost twice TWB as compared to the Samsung Evo, which is pretty sweet. For those of you sitting under the rock, TBW means terabytes written. Let's say your drive has 200TB TBW. That means after writing 200 terabytes of data, your drive will void its warranty, not cease to work. For this MX500 1TB variant, it is 360TB, which is a lot. Okay, versus the competition, the MX500 levels the Samsung 860 Cubo, the 860 Pro and the WD Blue 3D NAND, while at the same time costing less than all of them. Also, the 860 Cubo is programmed to perform better in benchmarks. It will perform worse in real life. This makes the MX500 a go-to and pretty much explains why I recommend this to everyone. But there are some caveats of this model. For starters, the lower capacity models, especially the 250GB and the 500GB, tend to be slower than the higher models of 1TB and 2TB capacities. Now, that's not fair. Also, the TBW tends to be quite low for systems having workflows involving huge read and write operations. The 860 Cubo has a 1440 TBW, which overshadows that of the MX500. But if you opt for the 1TB version and do not have workflows that involves huge read and write operations, the MX500 1TB version is a go-to. And that pretty much explains the situation of every consumer. Okay, for the bottom line, I pretty much recommend this drive to anyone, if he's on a budget or not. I'll leave links to buy this product down in the description. Go check them out. And with that said, I'm Arkil, and I hope to see you again in the next video.